See, we're back. It's like magic. We record a video, and then we come back after we figure out what next time we want to do. So this was a request. I got requested 10 songs by the same person. So I just wrote them down, and I do know this song. My mom, she used to say the song was a lot about my stepdad, who is now dead, Michael. He is the father to my youngest sister, Audrey. And one of these days, I'm going to have her here to do a reaction with me, because her reactions are a lot funnier than mine. Danielle knows this song. It had two options. I decided to go with the alternative rock mix. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. But it's called Bartender Song, Sitting at a Bar. And it's by Rehab. This song, I can't remember when it came out, but, I thought it was hilarious.
2000.
See, it's that old. So I'm kind of.
It was released in 2000.
I'm kind of doing this for Michael. Just because certain aspects, my mama always said it reminded her of their relationship. So, we're going to do Bartender Song, Sitting at a Bar, the Alternative Rock Mix by Rehab. Let's do it. About the trailer park, the love in the trailer park, and I'm pretty sure he did take her car one time. I don't think he crashed it, but I'm pretty sure he took it. But yeah, that was a lot like them. Yeah, this song is explicit, if you couldn't tell already. So if you're listening to it and you're not allowed to listen to the videos with curse words in it, stop listening. Yes, I do know practically every word to this song. And yes, that is a motorcycle outside my house. My cousin is here. I forgot how well I liked this group and how well they sounded together. And I don't know what the difference between the alternative rock mix and the other mix, but I'm still enjoying it the same. What about you?
Yep.
That's what I get. A yep.
Hey, I'm jamming.
She's jamming. Let's see what else he did. I'm sure it's something he shouldn't have. I love the beat. Love it.
You know, Mo, I'll probably get 10 years, so just give me beers till I get here. Yeah, I know the sun is coming. coming up, and y'all are probably getting ready for closing up. But I'm trying to drown my soul. I'm tired of this life on a dirt road, and everything that I love is gone. And I'm tired of hanging on. She got me sitting at a bar on the inside, waiting for my ride on the outside. She stole my heart in the trailer park, so I jacked the keys to her fucking car and crashed that piece of shit, then stepped guess away. So much for memories, and now I'm headed to the penitentiary. See me on TV.
He's heading to the penitentiary, which is also something Michael did quite often. I'm not saying anything bad about Michael Allen. I loved him to death, but the boy cannot go to probation to save his life, which is why he went to the penitentiary. Anyway. The fact that you can sing a song and then all of a sudden start rapping into it, that's talent. Because I can't even sing a song. So if you can rap and sing on the same track, good for you. Because that's a little bit above my pay grade. I can't even sing a song. And he's over here doing both.
Yep.
She stole his heart in the trailer park. So he grabbed the keys to her car and crashed it. Why? Does he not love her anymore?
Because she kicked... No, she kicked him out of the house and he was drunk and...
And she was high on some pills and tripping over the wheels.
Mm-hmm. But I don't know why she gets the wheels at 6 a.m.
I feel like this is everyday life in the trailer park. I shouldn't say that. People will be like, I live in a trailer park. Okay.
There is nothing wrong with living in a trailer park, people.
Oh, my God.
Not saying that. You do you and do the best you can with what you got.
My mom has lived in plenty of trailer parks. You should see some of the people she's lived with. I don't mean live with, literally. I mean lived around in the trailer park. Them bitches be crazy. Now I'm on a tangent about trailer parks. I just wanted to say, I was not trying to be rude about people in trailer parks. I'm just saying. I've seen it. This is not far from it. So let's continue back with him rapping.
The next cop series, I am a danger. I guess I should have did something about my anger, but I never learned. Real things that don't concern. I pour kerosene on everything I love and watch it burn. I know it's my fault. But
oh, that is so deep. I pour kerosene on everything I love and watch it burn. He basically says
he's very self-aware.
He self-sabotages himself and his relationships. That is a real ass lyric. I love when they get deep like that and you don't ever notice it until you're post, whenever you're making a video like this and you're supposed to be getting into the lyrics. But I mean, who has not done that once in their life? Poured kerosene on a situation just to watch it burn and watch it, you know, right in front of your eyes and it just completely screw up and you're like, I knew that was going to happen. I regret it now, but there's nothing I can do about it. I've done it plenty of times. But the fact that you can own up that you're doing it in this relationship, that he's owning up to it, says a lot about him as a person. That he's like, okay, I got problems, I know. But she makes me this way. So they actually have a toxic relationship. They should not be together. Because if we probably got her point of view, she would say the same thing about him. What do you think, Danielle?
Oh, yeah. She would probably say stuff even worse, let's be real.
I mean, he's self-sabotaging himself right now. That's why he's in a bar waiting for the police to get there. He already knows. Like, God, I really messed that up.
Wasn't happy, it was over. She threw a fit, so I crashed in pieces. And I'm going back again, back to the pen to see my friends. And when we all pile out that county van, they're gonna ask me where I've been. I've been at a bar on the inside, waiting for my ride on the outside. She stole my heart in the trailer park, so I jacked the keys to her fucking car. Crashed that piece of shit, then stepped away.
Like, did it have that one in the other version of him, like, singing there then? I don't know. There's a lot of versions of this song, apparently, because there's one featuring Hank Williams. No, I'm not listening to that version. I listened to the version, the rock alternative version. It was the very first one that popped up. And I do not regret the fact that I listened to that version. It was really good. I still love that song as much as I did back then. And it still makes me smile. It makes me laugh. And I also learned a new line. I pour kerosene on the things I love. Watch it burn.
Totally.
My final thoughts is I did not know he could sing like that. And if you're in a relationship like that, you need to get out because it's not healthy for either person. It is not. You shouldn't be with somebody that keeps making you go back to the penitentiary. You don't want to be in the penitentiary. It's not somewhere you want to go.
Definitely not.
Got any final thoughts?
Don't steal her car. Just saying.
Just
not cool.
Don't steal it and you won't go to the penitentiary.
Toxic relationships are bad. Yeah. Toxic relationships are bad.
Oh my God.
Okay, I think I covered everything.
Natasha, I think it was Natasha who gave me the suggestion. Thank you. If it wasn't Natasha, thank you to whoever it was. It brought back a lot of memories. And it was not about alcohol, even though it was called bartender, sitting in a bar. It was about a relationship that it's pretty much done and over with. Stay out of toxic relationships. It won't ever work. If it didn't work the first time, probably ain't gonna work the second time. Just saying. Peace out, people.